In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace to you, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. Very welcome here today at the Oxford Oratory for this celebration of marriage for Katie and Tom. It's a beautiful afternoon, and it's going to be a lovely celebration and a great evening too. Let's begin then by singing our first hymn, I the Lord of Sea and Sky. Katie, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you together with your families and friends, as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this, your joyful day. May he send you help from heaven and protect you. And may he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers.
Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all the wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if your salt becomes tasteless, what can make it salty again? It is good for nothing and can only be thrown out to be trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one puts a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on a lampstand where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in the sight of men, so that seeing your good works, they may give the praise to your Father in heaven." Tom and Katie, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
I have.
Tom, are you resolved to take Katie to be your wife, to love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her, as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Katie, are you resolved to take Tom to be your husband, to love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him, as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I am.
I am.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Anthony Thomas.
I, Anthony Thomas.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Catherine Louise.
Catherine Louise.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Catherine Louise.
Why I, Catherine Louise.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
Anthony Thomas Rob.
Anthony Thomas Rob.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Anthony Thomas.
Anthony Thomas.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Catherine Louise.
Catherine Louise.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Catherine Louise.
Catherine Louise.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Anthony Thomas.
Anthony Thomas.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
May the Lord, in his kindness, strengthen the consent you have declared before the Church, and graciously bring a fulfillment to his blessing within. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. Amen. Thank you. Katie, I give you this ring.
Katie, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. Tom, I give you this ring.
Tom, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Holy angels of God, watch over you and protect you. Our Blessed Lady Mary and all the saints of God in heaven pray for you. And may God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit bless you and be with you, now and always. Amen.
wedding, her handsome husband Thomas, Mr. and Mrs. appreciation for the very proud father of the bride.
Well, I'm not sure if I can follow that introduction, but anyway, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, and last but definitely not least, Father Alan. It gives me enormous pleasure to welcome you all to Blenheim on Katie and Tom's magical day. I am enormously proud today to see my favourite daughter married. Is a delight to my heart, if not my wallet. She looks wonderful and is glowing with immense happiness. Tom, you now have the challenge of ensuring that Katie continues looking in the future as blissful as she does today. I have very many happy memories of Katie growing up, from school, then university, now in business. While she was at school, I was particularly proud watching the Queen and Katie having a friendly chat. We have a picture of them with us, just ask if you'd like to see it. And then as I sat down to write this masterpiece, I was reminded of the words of commendation that were read out as Katie stood to be presented on her very last day at school with an award called the Founders Day Award. Awarded to her for being the exceptional pupil. She had been the head girl at her co-educational college. If you replace the word daughter for student, as I read the commendation, I think it should work. Enjoying this? I quote, "Could there possibly be a more modelled student in the country? She has supported and cared for those around her whilst managing to keep acutely focused on academic success. She'll be sorely missed by the Common Room as the leading mentor to all girls in the college on behaviour, sporting success, consistent cheerfulness and ambition. Katie has also been a perfect daughter, very similar to her school accolade." Just take it, Katie. I'd like to say enjoy yourselves and have fun. And it's now my pleasure to propose a toast to Mr. and Mrs. to Katie and Tom.
Please show your appreciation for the bridegroom, Thomas!
My wife and I... we'd like to thank you all for being here today. It really means a huge amount to us. To have you here celebrating with us. You're a truly amazing group of friends and family. We're so grateful. Welcome. And I'm done. So we started planning this 2 years ago, and we went into it knowing that weddings take a huge amount of organization, a huge lot of people. But looking back, it really is amazing just how much effort and energy has gone into creating this day. There have been so many people involved. There are people in this room and people working behind the scenes that have really gone above and beyond for us. And I want this as an opportunity to say very sincerely thank you. Thank you for your help, for your creativity, and for your support. We really, really appreciate it. Thank you very much. You guys have done a great job, and a specific thank you for organising a wonderful hen party in Brighton. I know Kate absolutely loved it. However, I am still in a bit of trouble for some of my answers to the Mr. and Mrs. quiz. I'll leave you to remember which ones those are. And to my groomsmen, to Mike, to Chris, that Chris, to Mike, and where's Chris? To Chris. So you might have seen a theme there as a bit of a top tip. If you're not particularly great with names like me, then marry into a family where your new brothers-in-law share the same names as your best friends. It works really well. Thank you both, thank you all for your help and support. Today has been 2 years in the making, and without you guys, it wouldn't have been even remotely possible. So we are deeply grateful, and we have two small signs of our appreciation for you now. It's traditional to finish the speech with a toast, so it's my very great pleasure to ask you all to stand and join me in raising a glass to the new Mrs. Robinson. Mrs. Robinson. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage the best man.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Michael, and I'm Tom's less intelligent, better looking, best man. Before I begin, I have a message from Chris, Nina, and Aidan, who couldn't be with us today. Dear Katie, we hope you have a wonderful day. We are sorry we can't make it over from New Zealand, but send our love. Come on, England! I'd particularly like to mention Vicky. My dearest Harriet tells me that you, amongst other things, organised the perfect hen do, and despite her best efforts to ruin it, went really, really well. Despite his flaws, I can honestly say that Tom is one of the best people I know, and I'll continue to look to him for advice and guidance. With the exception of fashion tips, I'll continue to look elsewhere. I literally had to tear those headphones away from around his neck. So what else can I say about our good friend Tom? Tonight it's good to see Tom relaxing and letting his hair down for a change. And it's a change. And it's a change to see Tom letting something down, because one thing's for certain, Tom, you'll never let down a friend. Aww. Kate, I'd like to take this opportunity to mention how beautiful you look tonight. You are thoughtful, charming, and continually remind Tom of how he's punching above his weight. So for that, I thank you. So nowadays, when I think of Tom, I don't think of him as a confident overachiever that I met in school, but I think of him as a team, part of a team, a super team, with Kate by himself. By himself? By his side. I'd like to propose a toast to Team Tom and Kate.
Team Tom and Kate. Got trucks on with St Aloysius. I gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. Too hot, hot damn. Call the police and the fireman.